Good morning, brothers and sisters. All right, this morning I was led to the book of Job, chapter 2. I'm going to start from 27 to 32 at the King James Bible, always King James. I'm going to explain my testimony and my transformation. I'm going to read this, and I'm going to read yesterday's daily devotion. All right, the Lord will pour out his spirit, but I'm going to start at 27. If you have ears to hear, focus up. If you have eyes to see, pay attention. And ye shall know that I am in the midst of Israel, and that I am the Lord your God, and none else. And my people shall never be ashamed. Don't be ashamed to be a Jesus follower, to have faith in true Christianity, not one world religion. And it shall come to pass afterward that I will pour out my spirit upon all flesh, and your sons and your daughters shall prophesy. Your old men shall dream dreams, your young men shall see visions, and also upon the servants and upon the handmaids in those days will I pour out my spirit. And I will show wonders in the heavens and in the earth, blood and fire and pillars of smoke. The sun shall be turned into darkness, hint, hint, and the moon into blood before the great and the terrible day of the Lord come. And it shall come to pass that whosoever shall call on the name of the Lord shall be delivered. For in Mount Zion and in Jerusalem shall be deliverance, as the Lord hath said, and in the remnant whom the Lord shall call. God called me November 18th last year, 2021. Now, I'm going to call it a rededication, because I've always been a believer of Jesus. Now, between my testimony and my transformation, I was disobedient. I was living in sin on and off. Now, I've been an usher at a local church, and I quit because they started preaching doctrines of devils. I'm not going to call the church name out. That doesn't matter. Use discernment to know the gospel, the true gospel of Christ, the gospel of the Holy Bible, one and only. I was 3 years old. I was at my papa's house. My mother was asleep tanning. I had arm floaties on. I was 3 years old. I wanted to jump off the diving board into the deep end. I took my arm floaties off, and I was like, I'm going to prove everybody. I was always, I'm going to prove this. I'm going to prove that. Well, I jump in, and nine feet of water, I drowned. Now, my Aunt Nancy was in the bathroom. My papa had the kitchen window open washing dishes. Now, when I drowned, I died for 5 minutes, and I saw heaven, saw 12 angels, and then I saw Jesus, and it was blurry, like, you know, when your eyes are open underwater and coming out, but I could tell my vision was different. It's indescribable. But the love and joy I felt, I've never felt it here on earth. So I long to go back to heaven. Well, Jesus said it's not his time to send him back. And then I bet you anything that when my mother said, God, please, Jesus, protect him with your angel wings and bring him back, I bet you they said it at the same time. And then I woke up coughing the water up out of my lungs, and I told my papa, I was like, where's those people at with the wings? I didn't know what angels was at 3. But then my papa was like, man, he's going to have a calling. He started teaching me the Bible. Now, it was between the Good News Bible and the King James Bible as well. I still got the, it was a golden Bible, says the Good News Bible. Okay. So Papa was teaching me the Bible at age 3. My mentality was as smart as a 7-year-old. Seven always comes to play with me because my social security number has 3 sevens simultaneously in order. And my first, middle, and last name all have 7 letters in it. You know, 777. It's not astrology or the angel numbers that people would, well, that's of the devil. No, 777 means the completion of creation. It's not up for debate. Shut your mouths. Don't be foolish. So then, October 7th of 2001, I got saved and baptized. As a baby, I was dedicated to God. I grew up Presbyterian Baptist, but now I'm in a Holiness Pentecostal church. Yes, I do speak in tongues. Now, in and out, I've been attacked spiritually. Like 2 days later after I woke up, I mean, you know, after the horrific incident of drowning and dying and coming back, I started seeing the spirit realm. I could see portals in the sky. I could see angels coming and going this way. And then I could see demons, shadow demons, kind of like what you've seen at the Travis Scott concert, if you have eyes to see. Now, when I was little, I tried looking at them in their faces, you know, I mean, they would move real fast, like away from me. The whole time I thought they was trying to scare me, I was scaring them because, you know, they can't look into the light. They can't comprehend. The darkness doesn't comprehend the light. Well, I was tormented throughout my whole life with shadow demons. I've been exposed to abuse of all kinds. But I can go in that house and tell you if it's haunted. There's no ghosts, there's no aliens, it's all demonic. Like, the worldly secular people want to, you know, tell you it's a ghost or it's haunted or, look, there's aliens in the sky. No, it's not. Do not be deceived. Okay? So, I even had encounters with a succubus demon. If you don't know what that is, look it up. Do your own research. Connect the dots. I'm not going to go in detail. Just imagine dealing with one or a few of them at age 3 all the way up to your adulthood. So, I come from, half my life was raised by my white family. My other half of my life, I was raised by a black family. So I was around hoods and projects and gangsters and drug dealers and just gang life, thug life, selling drugs, doing drugs. Well, last year in November, I was possessed. I even got video footage on my first YouTube channel called The Freestyle Assassin. And you can see manifestations in my very first video. You see the spirit of Jezebel sitting in the back seat with me and smirking and smiling every time I cursed or said GD. They love that. They love it when you curse. They love that they move through sound waves and frequencies like music and movies. Well, then God like anointed me, like I sanctified me after I was delivered, and I went through a stigmata for 3 days. The same lashes that Jesus Christ felt on his back, I felt on mine, and they would appear, disappear, and reappear for 3 days in a row. When it hit me, I'd be like, it'd take the wind out of me. And I would cry. And my wife and my mother-in-law saw it. It was like, who do we call? I mean, even my mother thought I was dealing with witchcraft, like performing witchcraft, but I wasn't. But they was trying to put me in a psych ward. And then I had an angel encounter at the hospital. Well, needless to say, I didn't go to no psych ward. After the third day, let me back up. When I seen when I was getting the lashes on my back, I was seeing lightning flashes of visions of what Jesus went through for us, for me, for you. Whether you believe it or not, use discernment then. Talk to God about it. Pray about it. And after the third day, I've been like this. I've been drug free since November last year. Now I caught a marijuana charge, and I'm doing drug class for it, but it's nothing to me. When I go to drug class, I witness to all the addicts in there, and I pray for them, and I tell them about God. Even gave a speech about what happened to me and why I don't go back to the streets. I don't backslide. I'm not lukewarm. I preach, I teach, I prophesy. I get dream visions and open visions, and that's why I read the book of Joel, chapter 2, 27-32. Listen, we are to be in the harvest field. Revivals are going to happen before the chaos comes. Or revivals are going to happen during the chaos that comes. And what's yet to come, what God showed me, I even tell this in my class, there ain't enough gangsters out there to endure it. You ain't hard. You witches, you ain't hard. You cult leaders, you ain't hard. You rednecks, you ain't hard. God's in control. God's in control of everything. He's allowing America to go back to the wilderness where it all started, like in the book of Genesis, man. How long did y'all think y'all was going to be able to kill babies and sin and fornicate and break the Ten Commandments before he sends judgments, pre-judgments our way, huh? How long you think it's going to last? When I seen y'all, thank you for all my subscribers, the new ones, and the people that comment, and the people that, you know, watch, and don't mock, scoff, and ridicule, and all that hate, and be Jesus haters online. That ain't gonna get you to prosper. That ain't gonna save you from the judgments coming. That ain't gonna save you from the wrath of God. That ain't gonna save you from demons and devils that's gonna come possess you. Activate your Holy Ghost. It's time to get right with God and stay right with God. Y'all ain't got too much more time. I've been saying this. Tony Lamb's been saying this. Now, I've also done this because I have a future interview with David Hefner. I'm about to be in the next episode of the TV series, The Last Evangelist. I made moves for God. I was spiritually attacked when I got back from my missions. I'm unshakable. Like I said, the spirit of fear don't live in me. I welcome it. You know, I welcome what God allows me to go through. It strengthens me. My eyes are aimed at the eastern sky 24/7 because I know the times and my dream vision, my warning dream visions of the amethyst dream, the airplanes dream, all my prophetic anointing dreams that I've been having, visions. I don't see men and women that are not of God making it. I ask y'all, seek your salvation. Jesus Christ came in the flesh. He died for us. He rose 3 days later. He ascended to heaven. He's got the keys, man, of life and death. Conquered the grave and death, man. Thank God. Because without Jesus, man, we're all damned to hell. We're going to all be damned to hell. It's biblical. And you're about to see biblical events take place. They're happening right now. Keep your eyes on Israel. Keep your eyes on Switzerland. Like, there's going to be evil, evil entities coming through. They're already here, but they're about to be amped up, boy. You ready for that? How you going to take on that outfit? Now, what's wrong with the church? God's going to shake the church up first. And then, simultaneously, the nations in this land, everything in front of me, behind me, beside us. This is a special prayer on my Jesus in Red devotional. The harvest truly is great, but the laborers are few. Therefore, pray the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest. I can remember when I got that evidence from that witch's daughter, you know, and regardless if they get paid off or not to not investigate or finish investigating those dead bodies on that 600 acre land in Wayne and Lewis County, Tennessee, God's gonna shake you up. God's in control. I ain't worried about y'all. Don't see y'all. Cutthroat the devil, you know. I remember bringing it to certain churches, just randomly. Can you help me figure this out? Can you? Scared. Oh, we don't want nothing to do with it. We just because we ain't got money to donate, huh? How you gonna call yourself a man or woman of God if you ain't casting demons out? And you ain't witnessing the people on top of mountaintops like me and Sister Janet do here in Huntsville, Alabama, huh? We are to be working for God, not sitting on the fence line, fence sitters, pew sitters. Really? Y'all think that's what the church is about? Y'all blind. And I say this out of love. It's always love, but sometimes y'all aggravate me, man. Like, y'all think it's, oh, look, take up offering. Let's have church. Let's figure out 15 ways to make our church better. Get out of there. Get out of the four walls of the Lord's house. The true church is out here witnessing. I'm not saying don't go to church on Sunday and worship the Lord and praise God. Hallelujah. Thank God for that, but the true work is out here. Out here in the field, in the harvest field. It is true that many hands make light work. The more help we have, the easier the task. Just ask anyone who has had to move his or her household. The task of reaching the lost is daunting. There are so many unsaved who have never heard the biblical gospel. Not religion gospel, not one world religion. The verse above is a command from Jesus to pray for laborers to enter the harvest field. He said the harvest truly is great. In other words, there are multitudes who are dead in their sins and few laborers to take the words to life to them. We are told to pray for more laborers. If you're not a laborer, you won't have a concern for the salvation of others. You won't bother to pray for laborers because your conscience will condemn you if you do. The enemy then gets a double victory. Why give the devil double victory? Y'all are being lazy. We had this saying, submit, commit, convict laziness to your sins. What are you? Talk, gossiping behind someone's back? Is that helping the body of Christ? Really? Threatening to whoop them, shoot them, kill them, stab them? Is that helping the body of Christ? Not only is there a shortage of laborers, but there is also a shortage of those who are praying for laborers. Please change that today by asking God to give you love enough to reach out to the lost and pray earnestly and steadfast for more men and women of God, laborers. Am I praying for laborers as I am commanded? Yes, I am. This is a question to ask yourselves. What can I do to remind myself? I remind myself that the laborers are less than how many people out there is lost. It's time to work, body of Christ. Father, please raise up and give us more laborers. In Jesus' almighty name, in the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach, amen. Like, it's time to get out of your seat. It's time to get out of your comfort zone. It's time to get off social media. It's time to quit watching Netflix and hogwash bullcrap on television. It's time to get out your comfort zone. Well, guess what? If you won't get out your comfort zone willingly, God's about to shake this nation. Thank God I welcome it. Man, let the economy crash. Let the one world currency come. Man, I wish it'd hurry up. The faster all these things come to pass, the faster Jesus Christ comes to take us at last. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise ye the Lord. You know, what y'all gonna do? You gonna be sitting there with your thumbs up your buttocks, huh? Oh, I don't want to pray for nobody. I don't want to go witness. What if they say this? Yeah, what if this? What if that? Yada, yada, yada. Man, get out there and have heart. Where's your spine at? Where's your spine at for the Lord? You're going to sit here and try to debate with me about, well, this, man, I don't. If it ain't got nothing to do with God, I ain't trying to hear it. If it's not godly movies or documentaries, I ain't trying to watch it. If it's not sound doctrine from that King James Bible, I ain't trying to hear it. We're supposed to be putting hands on people. We're supposed to be performing miracles. We're supposed to be bringing people to the church to get saved and baptized. Free 99. Free salvation, baby. It's your $1.99 highlighter. Huh? Listen, man. It's time to raise up. It's time to show spine. If it's against the Ten Commandments, where's your voice at? They always tell me, man, he's a mouth of the South. By God, I am. He's the big elephant in the room. By God, I am. What about y'all? Where's your big elephant in the room spirit? Where's your voice for God? Where's your voice for the brothers and sisters? Where's your voice for the lost? It's time to wake up. It's time to wake up. Quit being pew sitters, fence sitters. And that speaking out against people, breaking the Ten Commandments, living in sin comfortably. It's time to get up. It's time to move for God. You hear me? It's time to move for God. You know, this cross. Hear me. You know what I mean? Pray. Pick up your cross daily. Look, I'm going to show y'all something. It's time to pick your cross up daily. Anoint yourself with holy oil. Pick up your cross daily, baby. Huh? Sitting there whining and crying. Why this, why that? Well, sounds like y'all need to pray about it. Y'all don't find that interesting? It's time to move for God. Stop moving for yourselves and move for Jesus and your brothers and sisters out there that need to rededicate or become a brother and sister in the body of Christ. Y'all ain't got too much more time. Go to God. Dear God, please bless everybody behind this camera that misunderstands me, misinterprets me. Please, Lord, sanctify their ears, sanctify their spirit, sanctify their minds. Anoint them like you anointed me, Almighty Father. Give them dreams and visions and signs and numbers and confirmations, Lord. And the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, I plead the blood of Jesus all over this video and everybody that watches it. In Jesus' almighty name, amen. Go to God. You ain't got too much more time. Hallelujah.